Experience tonight is a Patch the Pirate adventure, a production of Majesty Music.
Majesty Music was started in 1973 by
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ron Hamilton, and this is my wife, Shelley. What you are about to experience tonight is a Patch the Pirate adventure, a production of Majesty Music.
Majesty Music was started in 1973 by my father, Dr. Frank Garlock, and was actually called Musical Ministries. My father traveled across the world, speaking to churches about the importance of godly music and began to produce music for church choirs. I met Ron and we married in 1975. We joined the ministry in 1978, just after Ron lost his eye, and the ministry was renamed Majesty Music.
I never planned to become a pirate. It just happened in a divine way. In 1978, cancer was discovered and resulted in the removal of my eye. When the surgeon removed the bandages a week after surgery, he gave me a black eye patch, a real-life prop
that thrust me into my role as a pirate.
Everywhere we would go, children pointed and exclaimed, "Look, a pirate!"
Hearing a doctor say that I had cancer was a very sobering experience. Many people would see it as a great trial having to lose my eye and the need to wear an eye patch, but I see it as one of the greatest blessings of my life. It reminds me of how God teaches us the deepest, greatest lessons in the deepest valleys.
Just after Ron lost his eye, he wrote a song based on Philippians 4:4, "Rejoice in the Lord." It's become a favorite of ours and many others as well.
We spent many years traveling, just as Shelley's father did, going around the United States and sharing our ministry with churches and families. Our five children traveled with us and all became pirates as well.
Jonathan was Pee-wee, Tara is Pixie, Alyssa is Peanut, Megan is Princess, and Jason is PJ.
Fast forward over 40 years later, Ron, or Patch the Pirate as he is lovingly called by most everyone, and I have written over 30 different musical adventures with character-driven, biblically based, and life-changing messages of the Gospel of Jesus. In 2010, Ron began showing early signs of dementia. And in 2015, God provided a new generation of leadership through Representative Adam Morgan when he married our youngest daughter, Megan, or Princess Pirate. Adam and Megan took over the ministry in 2018 and have continued to write scripts and music that are theologically sound, exciting, and have messages of hope for children and families today. Ron is still alive and living out his last days with a smile on his face and sometimes a smile on his lips. One time I asked him, "Do you realize how many people you've influenced for good with the music you've written?" Ron told me, "I like to think that God did it." We hope you enjoy tonight's production, Mystery Island.
Did you hear that? It moved again.
Are you sure?
Hamilton, hurry up with that equipment. You too, Private, get moving.
I can't, sir. I have to stand guard. I'm telling you, there's something out there.
Now don't start that again. The Japanese surrendered the silent days ago. They surrendered. The war is over.
There's something out there. I can feel it.
Get a grip, soldier.
Sir, what if there's a person out there?
I don't care if it's a monster or the Queen of England. The war's over and I want to get out of here. Get this equipment loaded now.
Right away, sir. What do you do with that box of food in your Bible? It sure is a funny time to be eating or preaching.
I promised I'd leave something for them. This is the most important thing I think I could leave them. I hope they find it.
Where are you going? Why do you keep going back to the jungle?
There's something I must do. I promised I'd give him answers.
Hamilton, what are you doing?
The war's over. We aren't heading home. There's something I must do. Gotta go.
Promise too. Are you crazy? You aren't even the enemy, are you?
There aren't any meetings anymore.
Hamilton, the Japanese all left. They're not here anymore.
I'll be right back.
I'm giving you 5 minutes and we're leaving.
Ah! Ah!
Quiet, you guys!
Take this pilot egg down so I can jump on your back!
Pee-wee, I don't think that's such a good idea.
No, Pee-wee. You might damage your spinal accessory, nerve.
Why, Alberta? You're ruining my story.
Pirates, it's getting late. I think it's time for bed now.
Keep reading. Let's give us a quick version.
Okay, now where was I? Oh, right. Pawpaw Patch never spoke of what he found in the jungle that fateful morning, but to this day, the island has been shrouded in mystery. In fact, ships dare not sail near the island for fear of disappearing.
That sounds scary.
Sounds interesting.
Disappearing? I don't believe it.
Actually, Precious, the island has a long history of inexplicable and bizarre phenomena, and ships have even gone missing in the area.
And locals say you can see strange lights in the mist at night.
No wonder people call it Mystery Island.
I changed my mind. I do not want to go there.
Ooh, I want to go there.
That's exactly where we're headed, Pirates. We should arrive sometime in the morning. My father, Pawpaw Patch, wrote about it in his journal, and we're finally able to take this trip.
What do you think we will find?
I don't know, Sweet Pea Pistol. Can you read that journal entry again?
Sure, Patch. Let's see where it was. Oh, here it is. When you take this voyage, follow this map and clue. so head to the island where mysteries abound, where something was lost and never was found. Where truth and belief lies buried today, go solve the mystery, do not delay.
Wow, now I will solve this mystery.
Maybe it's a buried treasure.
He doesn't specify that it's a buried treasure. Perhaps it's an unsolved mystery from the war.
Or maybe we're supposed to discover why all those ships have gone missing.
Well, crew, looks like we have a mission and a mystery to solve. Mystery Island or bust.
We'll have to proceed with caution. This may be our most mysterious adventure yet.
I can't wait to get to Mystery Island.
Me too!
Me three!
Marlin, rumored to inhabit these waters. When I find him, I will be a legend, and my life will be complete.
We'll be sure to be quiet and not disturb your fish. We're just heading to Mystery Island.
No, don't go there! It's a terrible place with a terrible monster.
A monster?
A monster? You have got to be kidding me. Doesn't anyone study science anymore?
Yes, it's a hideous beast. Go home and leave here at once.
What kind of beast?
He's a huge, terrible, what are you scared of?
Me? I'm scared of snakes.
Well, he's part snake!
Oh, no!
And, you, what are you scared of?
I don't like vegetables.
Well, he's part veg! No, that doesn't work. What are you scared of?
I'm scared of bats!
Well, he has giant bat wings!
He sounds horrible!
I'm scared, I wanna go home!
And yes, that's exactly what you should do! Go home, leave here at once, but do it quietly, I'm fishing. Oh yes, tell your friends that they are doomed. Doomed! Turn back!
I don't wanna go to Mystery Island anymore.
Crew, I think Santiago may have been embellished.
He was trying to scare us!
Well, he succeeded.
We always have someone protecting us.
That's right. Even when we're scared and face the unknown, we have a loving father who's watching over us. He loves us and can protect us from any old scary monster.
Even a half-snake monster?
even a half snake monster.
Crew, we have to face our fears and trust that God can always protect us. Even though we may not know what lies ahead, nothing is a mystery to Him. Coming near the coast now.
Wow! Good morning, everybody. Come and see how gigantamous the island is.
Island? I wish I could see more of it. That humongous ship is covering my view.
Patch, there's a ship arriving off the starboard bow, and it's a big one!
I see it, Alberta.
How can you miss it? That's the biggest ship I've ever seen.
It appears to be a giant yacht of some sort.
And look at the swimming pool on top of the ship, and all the people.
Orchestra on deck!
Is it just me, or is there a big fluffy bird coming out of that ship?
Pistol, that's not a bird. That's a woman wearing a high fashion accessory called a feather boa, which is nothing like a boa constrictor. But technically, it looks like she's wearing four of them.
Alberta, that's not one woman. There's three of them.
And they all look the same. They're triplets.
A boa, boa, boa.
Hello, friends! We have arrived!
Ahoy there!
Oh, Darla, Carla, these must be our movie extras.
Look at those pretty dresses.
And all those vintage boys.
I'm Starla, and these are my two sisters, Darla and Carla.
But you probably recognize us and know that already, though.
And this is Beauregard, our producer in charge of making us look fabulous. Aren't y'all our movie extras?
No, ma'am. We're the crew of the Jolly Roger.
We're here to solve the mystery of Mystery Island.
Solve the mystery? Oh dear. No, that just won't do.
You kids must have fallen off that rock and hit your darling little heads.
You cannot go on that island.
Can't? Why not?
Well, it's cursed, and that's why not.
Cursed?
Well, of course. Didn't y'all know that everybody that goes there is never heard from again? That place is pure evil. Nobody should be tripping around that island, let alone with darling little children. Why, that'd just be child endangerment.
Miss Starla, Darla, and Carla, we don't believe in any curse, but thank you for warning us.
Wait, if the island is cursed, why are you here?
Little old me and my sweet sisters.
We're here to fight it, of course.
Fight it?
Mm-hmm. We're gonna buy that creepy little island with all daddy's money. Ooh, I'm just so excited. Did y'all know there's actually little battles that happen there?
Of course, why in 1944?
And they left all sorts of darn little wartime memorabilia just lying around. Talk about the production ballad. It's gonna be the perfect real life set for our big blockbuster movie.
You're going to film a movie on Mystery Island?
Sure, sugar. It's a tragic wartime romance starring Starla, of course.
We're gonna take the silver screen by storm.
But aren't you worried about the, you know, the,
Oh, we know it's risky, and we're putting the lives of our crew in danger. But just think of the publicity. I can see it now. Triplet sisters brave the terrors of Mystery Island to film the biggest movie of the decade.
A bit lengthy for a headline.
With risk comes award, and in this case, it's gonna be an Academy Award. We're gonna be famous and remembered forever.
This is our breakthrough.
This is our moment.
This is our one big chance.
Beauregard, I said, this is our one big chance.
Yeah.
one of the awful medicine island, are you?
I wish you'd listen to us and stay away from there.
Well, I guess it's your funeral.
I guess we'll take their chances.
Bye-bye, Starla.
Bye-bye, Darla.
Bye-bye, Carla.
Well, y'all be careful now, if you can. All right, everybody, back to work. We got a movie to produce.
There seems to be a lot of people who don't want us on Mystery Island.
Did you see all her fancy clothes and makeup?
She had quite the tech crew with her.
I wish our ship had as many things as that crew ship had. We never have any fun.
Crew, those girls may seem like they're having a lot of fun, but the truth is all they were doing is living for themselves. The Bible says that that path leads to destruction.
I want to be a movie star too, just like Starla, Darla, and Carla.
That's right. Wanting to be famous and important are shallow and selfish goals. The Bible tells us not to live for ourselves.
You see, crew, everyone is building a kingdom.
We are?
Yeah, we either build our own kingdom by seeking after the things of this world and trying to please ourselves, or we build God's kingdom.
In Matthew, Jesus said, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God."
But what's the kingdom of God, and how do we build it?
The kingdom of God isn't a physical kingdom of this world, but a spiritual one. We build it by putting off selfish desires and worldly things and asking Jesus to reign in our life.
The kingdom of God is righteousness and peace and joy.
And Jesus commands us to go forth and make disciples in the world and build his kingdom.
Working, working every day, building the kingdom. Serving, serving is a way, building the kingdom. Give to those who are in need, love your friends and enemies, shining for the world to see. Building the kingdom.
Soldiers fighting for freedom here. It's moving!
What was that, Piper?
It's moving!
What's moving, Piper Pirate?
Patch, that tank is pointed right at us. Is it going to shoot at us, Commodore?
I sure hope not. That's not a very warm welcome to Mystery Island, though.
The tank's moving. Are we in danger, Captain Patch?
It sure does look that way, doesn't it?
I'm scared.
Okay, hold on. We're gonna have to run the Jolly Roger aground on the island.
What does that mean, Captain Pat?
It means the hull of the ship is gonna run into the ground of the island.
Okay, everyone, hold on. Is everyone okay?
I'm okay.
Me too.
Me three!
I think we're all okay, Captain Patch.
Did we get a hole in the hull?
I don't know, Pistol. Commodore, can you go check on any damage?
Aye, aye, Captain. I'm on it.
Look at the tank.
It doesn't appear to be moving anymore.
The question is, what was moving it? Or him?
Who?
Huh?
It's a subject, so it's who.
Grammar, really, Alberta? We almost got shot up. We're on the ground, and it's grammar you're thinking about.
You ended with a preposition. Actually, it was a compound sentence, and you ended both independent clauses with prepositions. Classic!
Alberta!
Hold on. Wait for me, and keep those terrorized expressions.
Someone's coming out of the bushes.
What is it?
I can't look.
Children? Oh, and they look so terrified. Oh, this will be so good for ratings. Here, honey, just look right here into the camera and keep that dazed, wide-eyed expression on your face.
What?
Welcome back to Unresolved Mysteries. I'm here with this little girl who just experienced something shocking and terrifying. Now tell America, little girl, what just happened here.
Well,
I heard a terrible noise. It sounded like an explosion.
The tank almost attacked our ship, and the Jolly Roger ran aground.
Did you say you were attacked with a tank? Oh, that would have made great television. Tell us more.
Who are you?
Oh, cut! Did you not see me filming? It's okay. Phineas Flabbergaster is the name. Genial host of the Emmy Award-winning daytime TV show, Unresolved Mysteries.
Unresolved Mysteries?
Yes. Unresolved Mysteries.
I've never heard of that.
It's basically a science show where we investigate unresolved mysteries, enigmas, conundrums, and use the scientific method to prove that everything has a perfectly logical explanation.
I love educational programming!
What's the scientific method?
Well, Piper, the scientific method involves six steps of investigation. Observation, research, forming a hypothesis, experimentation, analyzing the data, and reporting the conclusions. This method is typically used... Oh, sorry, I just got a little excited.
Mr. Flabbergaster, can you help us figure out how that tank attacked our ship?
Well, my dear friend, there's always a logical explanation.
There's always a logical explanation. When you have a logical point of view, do I do? There's always a plausible explanation. Hold fast to reason, try to see the mystery. Work through the scientific method. Hypothesize, adopt the eyes, and then surmise the facts. There's always a logical explanation. Expertise like hypothesis, you must consider that. Look at the facts first. A tank in isolation. Second, no suspect to be found. Profound. Third, signs of brusque intimidation. Fourth, a motive to run aground.
I'll give them that, but this time I'll show the world.
Just watch me, I'll prove the ghost exists, and incidentally prove I'm not insane.
He's not insane!
There's always a logical explanation. My integrity is plain to see. I'm an open book, no gobbledygook. There's always a logical explanation.
Welcome back to Unresolved Mysteries. On today's show, we have an undeniable instance of strange paranormal activity.
Phineas, I think you might be stretching the truth a bit there.
Oh, cut! Did you not see me filming? Oh, stay genial, Phineas. Sorry. I guess you're right. It may not have been a ghost. It could have been fairies. But my money's on a ghost. This island is practically crawling with them. And that's why I must insist that you leave this island immediately. Think of the children.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Ain't? Pistol, I really must inform you that.
I know, Alberta. I just like saying it that way.
Ugh!
I want to go home.
And that's exactly where you should go. Better safe than sorry you're not safe, that's what I always say.
Crew, we're not going anywhere.
You're not?
No, we have to make sure that Jolly Roger is ready for travel before we go anywhere.
Huh, I see.
Besides, we still have to find out what Pawpaw Patch sent us here to find.
That's right, Pistol. We have a mission.
Really? And what is this mission?
To solve the mystery of Mystery Island.
Find the something that's lost.
And to tell the truth that was unbelieved.
That all sounds like a bunch of gibberish to me.
Well, it means something to us, and we're going to solve the mystery that my father, Pawpaw Patch, left for us.
I have an idea. What if we split up? Some of us can stay here and repair the ship, and some of us can go and try to solve the mystery.
Wait. Split up? With danger all around? That's a great idea. In fact, it's the only logical thing to do.
Actually, Sally, I checked the hull, and the damage was minimal. I think we'll be just fine.
Well, that's good. No hole in the hole.
So, Phineas, I think we'll just stick together and solve this mystery as a crew.
Great. You think I can tag along? A dangerous trek through the ominous jungle is just the kind of footage I need.
Sure, Phineas. We can use all the help we can get.
Great. And your unresolved mystery should make great television.
Come on, everybody. Let's go exploring.
I love exploring. There's so many beautiful things to see.
Yes, and to think that God created all of this for us to enjoy.
I'm so thankful that God created all such beautiful colors in all the flowers and plants.
Yes, Winky, every part of creation is beautiful in its own way.
It's hard to think what creation would have looked like before sin entered the world.
Sin? Ooh, that's bad. I don't ever want to sin. Pee-wee, don't be silly. Everyone sins. Even Commodore?
Yes, Pee-wee, even I sin.
Pee-wee, sin is breaking God's commandment when we go against what the Bible says.
Like when you're supposed to clean your room and you don't do it right away and do what you want, is that sin?
Yes, Precious, it is. Whenever we think something wrong about someone else or try to hide our actions, that is sin.
Even what we think in our brain is sin?
Yes, Peanut. We want to do the right thing with actions, words, and thoughts.
I wish Adam and Eve hadn't sinned, and then the whole world would still be perfect.
I don't know about that, Pistol. The very first people God created chose to go their own way. God didn't make a bunch of robots that would always do the right thing. He created all of mankind with a choice, but also provided a way of salvation through his son, Jesus.
Chose the name.
know, this trek reminds me of the time I discovered extraterrestrial life forms in a retirement home in Hoboken.
Huh, this map that Pawpaw Patch gave us must be wrong. It says we should have reached some water by now. Doubloon Lagoon?
Doubloon Lagoon? Where did you get that map?
Captain Patch's father, Pawpaw Patch, gave it to us to follow. Why?
Doubloon Lagoon is just an old colonial legend, a place of fabulous treasure guarded by a fearsome warrior. Surely it can't be real, simply illogical.
Look, everyone, a lagoon!
Unbelievable.
Look, over there, by the water.
Is that gold?
We did it, Captain Patch.
We found the treasure!
Come on, Captain Patch, just open and see what's inside.
All right, Pistol, ready, crew?
Look, there's something coming out of the water.
What is it?
It's Merman. It's the only logical explanation.
Angad and Judah.
Hey, it's a swordfish.
Yeah, I see you've got a sword. Let's see if you know how to use it.
Ah, sir, I don't really need to hurt you.
That's what they all say. You fight like a two-legged land lover.
Big shot, Captain Patch.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can.
You leave us alone.
Everyone always retreats from the mighty flunge.
That's historically inaccurate.
Oh, I missed it.
Any chance you could go for round two, Captain Patch?
You leave us alone, Mr. Shark.
Well, you stay out of my lagoon.
He's not a shark, he's a swordfish.
Of course I'm a swordfish. Didn't you see the sword? Where'd you think the sword would be? On my nose? Ah, humans.
Sir, we didn't mean to try to steal your treasure. We didn't know it belonged to anyone.
Ah, well then, pardon my manners. I had mistaken you for brigands and thieves.
Who are you?
Ah, my name is Marlin Pierre Auguste Jean-Paul Diffin, at your service.
That's a mouthful.
I am a marine musketeer for the greatest kingdom on earth, and a most powerful, popular king. Long may he live.
And now,
when his servants the court of King Louis, you serve for the good of the crown. You must put on airs, it's your duty, and helps you stand out in the crowd. The king has the best world offers, a title and castles and crown. His subjects are one to stop any shot.
Served his king with honors and was the main course. Since then, my family has served the crown for generations.
I'm sorry to tell you this, Mr. Marlin, but Louis left the throne some 300 years ago.
He was thrown out in a revolution.
Revolution? But he was so popular.
Well, here's what happened.
Alberta, I think we'll save those details for another time.
Was this King Louis' treasure?
Wait. His troops brought it here when they first colonized the island many, many years ago. But when they left, they forgot about it. Since then, and then my family took it upon ourselves to guard it with our lives.
What's in the treasure box?
Hmm? Oh, 'tis incredible.
a treasure unparalleled in beauty and uncompromised in perfection.
But what is it?
I guess it's just what normally goes in a treasure box.
Is it candy?
I don't think it's candy, Pee-wee.
Have you ever looked inside, Mr. Marlin?
No, of course not. It is my duty to protect, not to peep.
You've guarded this treasure your entire life and never once looked inside?
Have you ever wondered what it is?
I must confess, I have desired to peep.
I want to peep.
Me too.
Oh, me three.
Okay, fine. But just a quick peep.
Yay, here it goes.
Wait. Okay, now I'm rolling.
Okay, here goes nothing.
It's empty!
What? No!
Well, it's not empty per se. That would be a vacuum, the absence of air. There's some residue in there and some silt.
You know, this reminds me of the time.
We're so sorry, Mr. Finn.
This lagoon is famous for its uniquely high concentration of muriatic and nitric acid, which can eat through gold. Nitric acid is colorless and is formed when ammonia over a platinum catalyst that high temperature.
Alberta!
This treasure was all I had, and now it's gone.
It's okay, Mr. Marlin. All earthly treasures eventually fall apart or decay. There are more things in life.
That's right. The Bible says, lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, where thieves break through and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven.
Yeah, treasures of heaven, just like what we were talking about earlier.
This reminds me of the parable of a man who found a treasure in a field, and he went and gladly sold everything he had so he could buy the field and get the treasure.
Well, I certainly hope for this man that his treasure is worth something.
It's the only treasure that is truly priceless.
They sound cryptic.
The parables, they come from the Bible. Jesus uses them to teach about his kingdom.
Tell me another one of these parables.
I know. Jesus says the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed, which is one of the smallest of all seeds. But when it grows, it becomes a huge tree with birds resting in its branches.
I don't follow.
It's a metaphor. When Jesus first taught about the kingdom of God, he only had 12 disciples. But as they spread the gospel across the lands, people from all over the world and all throughout the ages have entered the kingdom of God.
What started out small was so powerful and impactful that it grew and grew and keeps growing today.
Still not really making sense. Sounds mysterious and cryptic to me.
They may seem mysterious, but Jesus says the mystery of the kingdom of heaven is revealed to the people of faith.
Oh, I, like yourselves, am a person of faith. I can solve the riddle. Tell me another.
Well, Jesus taught that the kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his wheat field. But while he slept, the enemy came in and sowed tares, which are basically weeds, among the wheat. As they grew, he couldn't tell apart the wheat from the tares.
What did he do? Herbicides?
No, he waited until harvest time. And when they reaped the field, they could tell the wheat and the tares apart by the weight of the grain, which is quite the agricultural ingenuity. Then he had them bind up the tares and burn them.
Well, that's all very nice, but what does it mean?
I know, it means that there are a lot of people who claim to be Christians, but not everyone truly is. And though we can't tell the difference, God will separate those who did not believe from those who truly accepted Christ Jesus.
Are you implying that I might be an imposter? Someone who seems like a friend but is actually an enemy?
No, Phineas, we were just telling you the parables.
I'm shocked, I'm speechless, I'm tongue-tied that you would impugn my character in such a way. I don't want to hear any more of this parable gibberish.
That was odd.
There's something suspicious about Mr. Flabbergaster.
I like the parables. Tell me another one.
Is quite legendary. In fact, this reminds me of the time.
What is that?
Sounded like a bird of some sort. Or maybe a unicorn.
Something's not right, Princess. Where is everybody?
They're just a little ways behind us. I think I hear them.
Pirate sailors, we're up here.
What was that?
What is happening?
It's the monster. There really is a monster!
Princess, look out!
Let me go!
King Kong's nephew! It's a gorilla monster! Head for the hills!
It's a gorilla warrior! Princess, hold on! Get back, you oversized monkey!
What's happening?
Where did they go?
And what was that scary noise?
Quick, let's follow the tracks!
That is a mighty big footprint, Alberta.
Oh no, it's a monster track!
Princess, Captain Patch, where did they go? The tracks just stop here!
Drop your weapon, stranger!
Who are you?
Weapon first, question later. Arigato gosami! Keep your hands up!
Who are you and where are you taking us?
You are a prisoner of war, and I am Lieutenant Tanaka.
Prisoner of war? What war?
No funny business, Yank. Jumbo, tie them together.
Please, sir, let us go. There's been a misunderstanding.
No, my lady. No mistake. You will not leave here. You are now prisoners of the Empire of Japan.
Empire of Japan? There hasn't been a Japanese empire since World War II.
It's like we've fallen back in time.
Come on, girls, we have to keep moving. Stay close to me and Commodore.
Oh, I hope we haven't taken a wrong turn. These tracks go in different directions.
Face your fears.
What are you singing, Precious?
I'm singing a song about facing your fears. I'm kind of scared about what might be ahead. Are you scared of anything, Pistol?
Me? Of course not.
You're not even scared of spiders?
Or snakes?
Or the dark?
Not really. Those things don't scare me too much.
Is there something else that scares you, Pistol?
I guess so. It's just not something I really like talking about.
I'm here whenever you feel like talking, Pistol. I've known you since you were just a little guy and first joined the crew.
I know, and life as a pirate really has been the best. I've learned so much from you and Captain Patch, but...
But what, Pistol?
I kind of feel like I need to make my own decision.
A decision about what?
This might sound crazy, but I don't know if I want to keep living my life like this.
You mean this way as a Christian, Pistol?
Sort of. I just feel like it's a big deal, and it's really hard sometimes. But it's all I know. What if there's something else out there?
Those are great questions, Pistol. The real question you're asking is, do you believe that God's promises are true and he is faithful, or do you believe that you can control things without him?
When you put it that way, I'm pretty sure I know the right answer. But sometimes I don't feel like doing the right thing. It's just so hard.
That's something each of us wrestles with. If you take a look down throughout history, Jesus is the only man to ever keep every promise he ever made. That's because he wasn't just man. He was God.
Commodore, I know you're right. As I look back on my life, I can see how he has guided me and protected me every step of the way. So why is it so hard to give my life to him?
Oh, Pistol, that's something each of us wrestles with. This life sure isn't easy all the time, but I can tell you one thing for sure.
What's that, Commodore?
When we choose to give our lives to Jesus, we will never regret it. Even through the hard things in life and things that don't make sense, he will never leave us. He is there with us through it all.
Oh,
Thanks for the talk, Commodore.
Anytime, Pistol. I can't say I know all the answers, but I sure know the book I can find them.
Commodore, where are the cell towers? I don't have any service on my phone. Isn't the geosynchronous satellite supposed to connect to my phone and give me continuous data? Where are we anyway?
Whoa.
What is it?
It looks like someone is constructing a factory.
But I thought the island was deserted.
Wait a second. I think this is a coffee farm.
On Mystery Island?
Look what I found. Fishing nets and a bunch of giant sacks.
Big Buckle Coffee Corp.
What is that?
Yes, I have service! Big Buckle Coffee Corp is the world's largest international supplier of exceptionally highly caffeinated coffee. Known by its trademark logo of a belt buckle, making it vastly popular with horse riding men wearing belts, bandanas, and large belt buckles.
Does that phone tell you everything?
Well, Pee-wee, so far it's told me everything I've asked it. Except, of course, what's for dinner.
But how do these big coffee bags get here?
I don't know, but it doesn't look like any variety I've ever seen. It could be a new species, whatever we do.
Hey guys, look what we found.
Precious Pixie, you drank the coffee?
I don't know, we just found this nice cafe over there. I drank this whole cup.
You found a random cup and drank out of it?
Oh dear, first of all, that's completely unsanitary. Think of the germs. And second of all, children should not drink coffee.
Why not?
Precious, how do you feel?
Well, I feel...
Served a greater purpose.
But you must believe us. The war is over. You can go home.
Go home? Would my home even be there anymore? Everyone I know is probably dead. I turned 98 this year. 98. I've been on this island for 77 years.
I know it seems impossible to believe, but we're telling you the truth. The empire you served has fell and has gone away.
But there is a much greater purpose that you could live for, a kingdom that will never pass away, that you could join, the kingdom of God.
The kingdom of God? What do you know of this? Have you read the Bible?
Well, yes, we're Christians, but have you?
Impossible coincidence. You remind me of a man who once had tried to tell me that the war is over, but he was the enemy, and so I did not believe him. But everyone was abandoning the island. The Japanese had gone, and now the Americans were leaving. He gave me food and this book, this Bible.
Captain Patch, that must have been Pawpaw Patch, your father. That which was lost wasn't a thing. It's a person. It's Tonica.
And the truth unbelieved must be that the war has ended, or could it be that the gospel was never believed?
Yeah.
This kingdom you speak of, I have read it about it in here. I have almost believed it, but How can it be true?
It is true, Lieutenant.
Wait, listen.
Ka-ka!
Drumble, go see what it is.
Ka-ka, ka-ka!
That sounds like a bird in a pen.
Ka-ka, ka-ka!
No, that sounds like a lady imitating a bird very badly. Attack! I use my double duck and monkey man to go wilderness survival now.
We are victorious! From henceforth I shall be called Gorilla Girl, the one who defies fear!
Yeah, Gorilla Girl, the one who defies fear.
It's who defies fear, not whom.
What happened to you guys?
You'll never believe it. We got lost in Jacob, Bowser, Cotton, Granite, Circle, James, Malcolm, Tiger, Chat, Man here just broke up eating the best kid, you can the monster.
And I discovered the cure for the common cold, created a new iPhone made of banana peels, and tackled a whole army of guerrilla warriors.
Kids, you're too young for coffee.
It's fine. I promise, really, it doesn't even affect us. We're cool, we're calm, we're collected.
Do you know these wild children? And do they always twitch like that?
Yes, well, no, but they are part of our crew on the Jolly Roger.
Oh, where did you get your Jango? I want one.
That is Jumbo. He was stranded here after his ship was wrecked.
The real question is, who are you?
I am Lieutenant Tanaka of the Imperial Japanese Army.
The what?
He thinks World War II is still happening. He's been hiding on this island
for at least 77 years. Astounding! This is a major historical discovery.
Really?
Why, yes. He is a Japanese holdout, which is a term for Japanese soldiers living on remote islands in the Pacific, refusing to believe that the war had ended. The last documented holdouts were Lieutenant Hiro Onoda and Private Nakamura back in 1974, but others have been rumored to be seen or found as late as 2005.
I know Lieutenant Onoda, but how could this creature know his name unless what you say is true? Can it be?
I'm sorry, Mr. Tanaka. I know this must be hard.
Go. Leave me.
Mr. Tanaka, you mentioned you have a Bible. Don't you want to know what it says?
I know what it says about God and Jesus and everlasting life, but how can it be true? It seems too wondrous, too fantastic.
Well, until a few seconds ago, you believed a lot of things that were wrong.
And didn't believe the things that were true, but that didn't make them less true.
Everything you read in the Bible is true. Jesus loves you and died for you, and all you have to do is have faith in him to have eternal life.
Could he really be the answer and forgive me, an old man who has rejected him for so long?
Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord
shall be saved. Can it be?
Today.
I do believe. I accept him.
Oh, Lieutenant, that's wonderful!
Commodore, do you think Lieutenant Tanaka is what Pawpaw Patch want us to find on Mystery Island?
I sure do, Sally.
What was that?
Look, over there, coming out of the shadows.
What is it?
Oh no, it's a ghost.
It's a monster.
Quick, get behind me.
He's coming closer and he has a sword.
What are we gonna do?
Lieutenant, where's my sword?
It's over there by the monster. Oh, I know. Jumbo can help.
He's still tied up over there.
Oh, that is unfortunate.
No fear, mon ami. Your fighting friend Swordfish is here.
Marlin, help us fight the Mystery Island monster.
Mr. Willingly, where is he? Yeah, I'm God. Have no fear, I will protect you.
I got him.
Just as I have suspected, our monster is no monster at all. Merely a ne'er-do-well hiding behind a costume made of coffee bags.
But who could this be?
I know who he is.
Really?
Yes. Our fake monster is none other than Miss Starla. She wants Mystery Island all to herself and wants everyone to think the island is haunted. Her daddy was taking too long to get rid of us, so she took matters into her own manicured hands.
No, no, no. It's not Stella. I know who the monster is. It's old Santiago, the fisherman.
Oh, I know who he is. He's always giving me free snacks and treats from his boat. He's a nice guy.
Marlin, that's not snacks. That's bait.
Bait? Oh, yes, that's a good one. Wait, really?
Santiago doesn't want anyone to come to the island and scare away his fish. He'd do anything to keep the tourists away, so he dressed up like a monster to make spooky noises at night.
You guys are both incorrect. I know who the real villain is.
Maybe we could just take off the mask and see who it is.
All in good time, Lieutenant. You see, this all comes back to one thing. Coffee.
Coffee?
I love coffee!
And the motive of our villain is neither fame nor fishing, but rather fortune. And our villain is... it's stuck!
Phineas Flabbergaster!
Actually, no. Phineas Flabbergaster is merely an alias.
An alien? He's from outer space?
No, Pee-wee. Alias can be defined as an alternate name for someone to cover their specified identity.
Hey, I learned a new word!
I was suspicious when Mr. Flabbergaster was the first one to arrive on scene after our phantom tank attack. Then I noticed he didn't have any film crew with him for his alleged TV show. A TV show he made up and knew no one would question because no one watches daytime television!
What is he? Television.
But if it isn't Phineas, who is he?
Whom?
No, Pistol, it's who. His real name is J.D. Big Buckle.
J.D. Big Buckle, the coffee baron and supplier of the world's highly caffeinated coffee beans that are shipped all over the world?
The very baron. But why? He didn't want anyone to discover this island's real treasure. Its abundant natural resources of...
I know! Really caffeinated coffee beans!
That's right! My grandfather searched for these beans for years to no avail, and I finally found them! I was going to be the first to launch a new line of beans so potent it regrows hair.
Ew.
And I would have gotten away with it too if you pesky kids and your crew had gotten in the way.
Well, crew, I think we can say this mystery is solved.
Yeah!
I'm ready to go home. This has been quite the adventure.
It sure has. We've met up with some pretty strange characters.
I'm thankful we were able to solve the mystery, but I think I'm ready for life on the sea again.
I get that. Sometimes I need to step away, just step away from the excitement, and just be quiet.
Do you know, I have a secret place on the Jolly Roger that I go to when things get too crazy.
You do? Where is it?
Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be a secret, would it?
I guess you're right.
It's the best early in the morning. I go there, it's quiet, I can see the sunrise and talk to Jesus and read my Bible.
Oh, that's the best, Sally. I have a place like that too.
You do? Where?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Is everyone ready to shove off?
Yoo-hoo!
Ahoy there!
Y'all leaving so soon?
Just as we're turning this place into a movie set and a tourist destination.
We're off on our next adventure.
Y'all sure you don't want to stick around and be extras in a blockbuster movie? It could be your one big chance.
No thank you, Strella, Jarla, and Carla. Maybe some other time.
Well, y'all have fun preaching or whatever it is y'all do.
Speaking of which, we wanted to tell you more about the Bible before we leave.
Oh, yes. Well, you know, we're from the Bible Belt and all that stuff y'all were talking about
sure sounds interesting and familiar, and we'd love to hear more about it.
Great. Well, as we were saying...
Once you know it, there's my cue. Gotta run. Ta-ta, friends. See you on the silver screen. Oh, forgot where is my hairspray.
Thanks for what you said. I want to know more, but I need to go.
But we didn't finish telling her about Jesus.
I think Miss Darla is the thorny ground.
You mean from the parable?
Yeah, the seed is sown, but soon the cares and pleasures of this world rise up and choke the seed.
What can we do?
It seems that one of the sisters might be the good soil. She wanted to hear more. We could pray for the people in our lives who don't know Jesus.
And that's why we keep sowing the seeds of God's word.
That's why I have decided to stay here on Mystery Island.
You're not going back to Japan?
No, my military mission may have ended, but I have a new mission and a new kingdom to serve. To witness to all the inhabitants, and to Miss Darla, and Miss Carla.
That's wonderful, Lieutenant. That's exactly the mission that God has planned for each of us.
To go forth, make disciples, and to spread the kingdom of God.